Catherine.
And Nancy.
Nancy, how are you?
And Suzanne.
How do you do, sir?
Suzanne.
And Rob. And my husband.
I was supposed to have seen you.
Well, good to see you. Why don't we all gather around and have a family picture? Why don't you come over here?
See the parents? You know, I know where you might be there.
I know that's where you're going, yes. And I just thought as a little souvenir here, it's just something that reminds you of us, but also, all when he puts all those papers on, you grab the hold of it.
Oh, isn't that nice? Thank you.
Thank you.
You like that, don't you, Kathy? Okay.
Well.
Thank you, sir.
Well, good luck.
Well, we keep you busy.
I know. I'm just comforting myself that you're not too far away.
That's right.
Thank you for always here. Appreciate it.
All right. Bye. 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 How are you?
Good. I wanted to tell you how much I appreciated the honor, actually the singular honor of serving on your staff as a special assistant. And I particularly appreciate the confidence that you placed in me and nominating me to be general counsel of the Department of Commerce.
Well, I want to thank you for all that you've done here, and I say it isn't really a goodbye, you're just changing positions on the team.
Well, I think the Secretary Baldridge is really a first-class cabinet officer, and I'm looking forward to being his counsel over there, and certainly being a part of your team. That's
important enough. There's just something to keep the papers from blowing away on the desk.
Thanks again, Ray.
All right. Good luck.
Thank you.
Hi. Well, nice to see you. You turn around and get a picture.
Okay.
Stanley, I'll probably be covering you the next 4 minutes. All right, we'll see where Molly.
Can we turn the lights on for safety to read and plan?
Yeah. I mean, what's in the red folder?
There.
Man, right in the money. Board.
Put it right on your nose. Okay, let go. That's it.
How'd I do?
Did you realize how dumb you look?
4-2.
125,
42,
20.
Yeah.
Thank you.
How many people?
Everybody happy? You got about 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10. Including the president.
Lights down.
Turn the mic down.
Well, I'm delighted to have you here for this signing, H.R. 1869. Repeals the requirement for a very extensive regulation, an unnecessary one, I think, on people who use business vehicles for private purposes also. And I'm glad to have you here. And it's just a part of what I hope will be a larger tax reform later, and so we can all be together for another signing, but more about that next week.
We're looking forward to it, Mr. President.
I hope the rest of tax reform is as easy as this one was, Mr. President. I somehow doubt it.
You and me both.
Yeah.
Man, this is good. gladden the hearts of a lot of Americans, because I know that you had their, the public support in this.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate you doing it. It's a good deed. Pleased to do it.
We're glad that you did that for the American working man and woman. That's what that's all about.
Particularly in my district. Thank you, Mr. President.
I think we can...
Great for the people.
We can remove a few regulations.
Mr. President, I'd like to give one of those pens to Jim Abney.
It's another one of those pens for giving away, too, Mr. President. It's another one of those pens for giving away, or one has to go to the archive.
We'll archive it.
You mean the one in Nebraska?
Mr. President, shows common sense and logic prevails.
Thank you.
First stage in tax reform. That's what I told Mr. Baker when he testified.
That was a down payment.
That was a down payment.
I wish all our battles on deregulation were this easy, Mr. President.
Yes. I do, too. I think we've got a lot more to go.
Mr. President, didn't you know this was in the bill last year? Didn't you know this provision was in the bill last year? Why did you sign it last year with this onerous provision in it?
Well, because I didn't have line item veto.
Mr. President, do you think the House version of the budget is really going to hurt national security?
I think I'm going to wait and register my opinion when I get to the conference. You're
concerned about it, though?
Yes, I am concerned.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Just had said she had passed. She had immediately. She said, "Yeah, I thought I was pretty bubbly." She said, "No, no, no." She said, "I don't mean your speech." Dinner partner. She felt sorry for you, though.
You're right.
When you need some advice, call.
I'll come in either way. It's just up to you. I don't mind if it's good that way. I don't know that I'm paying my wife to think it's good because I can't.
All right, why don't we leave it this way? I'll wear a sport jacket unless I hear differently. And all you got to do is relay it through the... Thank you. Well, come in. Let's sit down here for a minute. Sit down here.
Have you seen the movies?
Yes. My only regret was I didn't think they made it evident enough that it was the those people that were responsible for all of that. I was afraid that some of those people might not be familiar enough with them. Who were the bad guys?
I'm very glad to have seen this very optimistic.
It adds to about 40 since 82, and we've recently put in another 2.5 million and more to follow.
And I'm very glad that I gave you your time the second day that you really made a good guideline that keep let the refugees come. And I want to mention more important also the humanitarian emergency aid that those people now this monsoon, and they need